So let's say you're an artist or a photographer and you need to create a portfolio. The portfolio probably needs to be in PDF format to submit it to galleries, schools, wherever you're going to send it. So you've got these JPEG images and now you need to create PDFs. Now you may be tempted to convert the JPEG images to PDFs using Preview or some other image editing app, but you're probably better off actually creating a nice portfolio document using Pages. For instance, I've got some pictures here. Let's create a portfolio using a few of those. So I'm going to run Pages here. I'm going to create a new document. Now depending upon the requirements, you may want to choose, say, a vertical or horizontal one. Let's do a horizontal one. And I'm going to convert from the standard word processing document to page layout by going to File, Convert to Page Layout, and convert it there. Now let's go and show layout here so I can see like the top and the bottom. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so I can see the entire page. And I'm going to now add in some of those images. So let me grab an image. I'm just going to drag and drop it in. So I can put it here. I can use these guides to kind of put it where I want. I can turn on rulers. Maybe you can even get a better idea where things are at. So we can put this image here. And I can stretch it to be, you know, full screen. And I've got some space at the bottom. And I want to use this space. So I'm going to create a text box here. And I'm going to put, you know, maybe a title. You know, maybe make that bold and a little larger. You know, maybe, you know, maybe some sort of date there. You know, make that a little smaller, not bold. You know, I can do whatever I want here with this text box. You can get real fancy with it. I'm just going to keep it simple. So I've got that. I also want to select it, maybe put a border around it. Something simple. I mean, I could do something like this. It leaves a little bit of space. Or I could just do, you know, a solid line with a shadow, that kind of thing, or just the shadow itself. Let's do that. It leaves a little bit of a space around it there. Maybe now I want to adjust it in to compensate for that border. So now I've got kind of what I want there, and I can go ahead and do the same thing for the next page. So I'll go and add a page. What might help is if I show the page thumbnails on the left so I can see the pages there, two pages. I can bring in another image. So I'll bring that one in. And I will do the same kind of thing here. I'll use the same border for consistency. I will line it up the left and right the same way. Maybe even to keep things consistent, I'll copy this text box and go over here and paste it in. And then change that there. So I've got that. Now I can do other things if I want as well. For instance, I can add a page and I can move it around. So I can put this page here at the top. And maybe this is where I create, you know, I put my name, you know, whatever is required of you there. So maybe I can just have that there at the bottom left and make it a little bit bigger. You know, so it's a page like that. I can even add an image maybe here if I wanted to. So after I create my nice portfolio, adding as much text as I want, adding borders and all sorts of things, I can even do a page maybe that has like four images on it instead of just two or just one. Then I can simply do File, Export To, and say PDF. And change it to PDF. I probably want to use best image quality for something like this. I'll save this out to the desktop. And now I'll hide that. I'll see here I've got my PDF here. Standard PDF. Now I can send it to anybody on any machine that can read PDFs. And they've got a nice portfolio, much nicer than just converting a bunch of image files to PDFs.